Jatam sahagana ragnatanvitam tam sajevam sadvaitam savadutam parijana sahitam krishna chaitanya devam shri radha krishna padam sahagana lalita shri vishakhanitam scha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha kripa sindhu bhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading Srimad Bhagavatam. So today we're beginning the sixth canto. And the sixth canto begins first with the story about the life of Ajamila. So Maharaj Parikshit is talking to Sukadeva Goswami, and he tells Sukadeva Goswami, he said, you know, in the second canto, you told us about the path of liberation. And
Maharaj Parikshit 给 Sukadeva Goswami 说，您在第二篇的时候讲述了解脱之途。
So, by if we follow that path which you gave us in the second canto, we can go to the Brahmaloka, the highest planet in the universe, and from there we can go to the spiritual world.
您说，如果遵循那个途径，一个人可以被提升到 Brahmaloka。而通过 Brahmaloka, 一个人可以被提升到灵性世界。
And from Brahmaloka, you have to wait for the end of Brahma's life. And then, at the end of Brahma's life, then you can go with Lord Brahma into the spiritual world.
在 Brahmaloka, 在等到这个 Brahma 生命结束的时候，你可以跟着 Brahma 一起回到灵性世界。
And this way, you don't have to take birth.Again, in the material world.
这样的话，你就可以不用在这个物质世界再一次投生。
So Maharaj Parikshit, he was a devotee, and he had heard the fifth canto. Previously, we were talking about the hellish planets and all the miseries there.
Maharaj Parikshit 是一位奉献者，他在第五篇的时候聆听的有关于地狱的不同的描述。
And he was very worried about how to liberate the conditioned souls, how to save them from all this suffering.
他非常关注于这些受条件限制的灵魂，非常关心于他们是怎是是是如何，非常关心如何将他们从这些痛苦之中解脱出来。
So he reminds Sukadeva Goswami. He said, "Previously, you told us about the path of how to get liberation." Have to get free from material bondage.
Parikshit Maharaj 说，在之前你已经给我们讲述过如何从束缚之中得到解脱的这种方法，解脱之途。
So Maharaj Parikshit, he's also coming close to death. He's cursed to die, so he's also got to prepare for death.
Maharaj Parikshit 也非常接近于死亡，因为他受到的诅咒，即将死去。
So he'd asked Sukadeva Goswami about this earlier. He'd asked him about how to prepare for death.
因此他在之前的时候也问过 Sukadeva Goswami 如何准备死亡。
And Sukadeva Goswami was very happy that he was asking this question.
Sukadeva Goswami 非常高兴他问这个问题。Gurudev, 你稍等一下，我开一下灯。Okay.
So Maharaj Parikshit was eager to help people to get out of the suffering condition.
Maharaj Parikshit 非常渴望帮助人们从这种受条件限制的状况之中得到解脱出来。
A real devotee is always unhappy when he sees other people suffering.
一位真正的奉献者，他总是看到别人受苦的时候，他感到很不快乐。
Right. In the material world, you get materialistic people, they're happy when they see other people suffering.
但是对于物质主义者，他看到别人在受苦的时候，他会感到快乐。
But devotee doesn't feel happiness when he sees people suffering. He feels sorry for them.
但是奉献者看到别人的这种糟糕的处境的时候，不会感觉到快乐，他感觉到充满了怜悯，非常悲伤。
One devotee in Australia was he told me, I met this one devotee from Australia, he told me, he said he was in the car with Prabhupada one day, they're coming from the airport, and it was early morning, and he could see all the people going to work in the factory.
有一个奉献者，他来自澳大利亚，他跟我讲述这么一个故事，他说有一次圣帕帕德跟着这个奉献者一起在早上很早的时候在车里面看到人们非常早的 就去工作。
So he was laughing, he was thinking, look at these fools, they're going to work in the factory.
然后这个奉献者当时就在嘲笑，他说这些很愚蠢的人，他们那么早就要进到工厂里面去。
But he saw Prabhupada was sitting with tears in his eyes, and Prabhupada was thinking, they're so unfortunate.
但是他看到圣帕帕德眼睛里充满了泪水，他觉得这些人竟然是那么的不幸。
So when Parikshit Maharaj heard about the hell and all the different hells which are there, then he asked Sukadeva Goswami to tell him more about how to get freed from birth and death.
因此，当 Parikshit Maharaj 听到 Sukadeva Goswami 描述这个地狱是如何的糟糕的时候，他也希望。从 Sukadeva Goswami 那里聆听到更多的关于如何从地狱之中得到解脱。
So we should want to finish the birth and death. We're not eager to come back again.
我们希望结束这个生死的轮回，我们希望再也不要回来。
So sometimes people they'll take the process, they'll begin karma yoga.And then they'll do Jnana Yoga, and then they'll come to Bhakti Yoga.
通常情况下有很多人他们开始做的是 Karma Yoga, 行动瑜伽、活动瑜伽或业报瑜伽，然后到 Jnana Yoga, 思辨瑜伽，然后最后才到奉爱瑜伽。
But it doesn't have to be like that, because Bhakti Yoga is so powerful, you can begin immediately doing Bhakti Yoga.
但是一个人也不必这么间接的去做，他可以直接从奉爱瑜伽开始，他直接立即就可以从奉爱瑜伽开始。奉爱瑜伽非常有力量。
Even the person may be very sinful, he has no pious activities.
即便一个人非常的罪恶，他根本就不虔诚，没有做很多的虔诚活动。
He never did any nice pious activities to help people.
他从来没有做过那些虔诚的活动来帮助其他人。
Or he may have no knowledge at all about what is matter and what is spirit.
他甚至根本就没有关于灵性或物质方面的有关的知识，他不知道什么是灵性，什么是物质。
So he can't really do karma yoga and he cannot do jnana yoga, but he can do bhakti yoga.
因此他根本无法做 karma yoga, 也无法做思辨瑜伽，他只能做奉爱瑜伽。
And if he does bhakti yoga, he can go back to Godhead.
但是如果他做奉爱瑜伽的话，他能回归守神。
But the yogis, they cannot go directly to the spiritual world.
对于瑜伽师，他不能直接回归灵性世界。
Sometimes they want to go and see other planets, they want to go and see where Lord Brahma lives, we want to go there.
有时他们想去到其他的星球, 比如说 Brahma 所居住的星球, 他想去那里看一看。
Then they have to wait for the end of Brahma's life before they can get out of the material world.
那他去到那里之后, 他就得等到 Brahma 生命结束的这个时候, 他才能够离开这个物质世界。
So the Brahma lives a long life, they have to wait for the end of Brahma's life.
但是 Brahma 的生命如此之长, 他必须等到 Brahma 结束之后, 他才能够离开那个地方。
So unless, and Maharaj Pariksit said that we have to get free, the living entities, they have to get free from the material energy.
Maharaj Pariksit 说, 一个生物体必须免于物质自然属性能量的影响。
If they have to take another body, then they will suffer in the material world.
如果他们又得到另外一个躯体的话, 他又得在这个躯体里面受苦。
And you get a material body, then we'll think about enjoying, and we'll want to go and enjoy in the heavenly planets.
如果他有一个物质躯体, 他还会想着想要去高等的星球上去享受。
So sometimes people worship demigods so that they can enjoy the material world.
因此有人崇拜半世人, 他就想要的是可以享受这个物质世界。
People worship, sometimes they will worship ghosts and spirits.
有时他们崇拜鬼魂和精灵。
Sometimes they worship the ancestors.
还有一些人崇拜祖先。
So it depends on what mode of nature, what position they're in, what kind of material energy they're under.
这一切都取决于他们受何种物质自然属性的影响。
And according to their situation in the material energy, they'll get that destination. If they're in the mode of passion, they'll go, they'll get a passionate body. If they're in the mode of ignorance, they'll get the ignorant body.
根据他们受不同的物质自然属性的影响，他们会得到不同的躯体。如果他们受激情属性的影响，会有一个激情形态的躯体；如果有一个愚昧受愚昧属性的影响，他会有一个愚昧形态的躯体。
So long as we have a material body, we'll think about enjoying. And people, if they want to, the highest enjoyment is to go to the heavenly planets.
只要我们有这个物质躯体，我们就会想着要去享受。而在这个物质躯体里面，他们非常想要去到天堂星球上去享受。
People have no information about Krishna, about the Supreme Lord, and about the spiritual world. They only know about the material world.
但是人们对灵性世界，对Krishna，对灵性世界完全没有概念，他们只知道这个物质世界。
But even they go to the highest planet in the material world, even there, there's birth and death. So there's no safe place anywhere.
但即便一个人去到高等的星球，在高等的星球里也会有生和死。 因此在这个物质世界是没有一个安全的地方的。
But if one can go back to Krishna, then he'll never come back to the material world.
倘若一个人回归守神的话，他绝不会再来到这个物质世界。
So people are wandering in the material world, and when they're fortunate, then they get the seed of devotion from the spiritual master.
在这个物质世界，如果一个人很足够幸运的话，他从一位真正的灵性导师那里得到分外的种子。Then
by the mercy of the spiritual master, he gets the mercy of Krishna.
而灵性导师他是从 Krishna 那里得到仁慈。And
the seed of devotion is planted in the heart, and it begins to grow.
而这个分外的种子会在这个人的内心里开始成长。
So sometimes we're going up to the higher planets in the material world, and sometimes we're going down to the lower planets.
有时生物会去到高等的星球，有时生物也会堕落到低等的星球。
We're looking for enjoyment. We go up looking to enjoy, and then we can't find it. We have to go down into the lower planets. We can't enjoy there either.
有时他会去到高等的星球上想去，有时他也会到低等的星球，他也会在那里，他那里也有享受。
But when we're intelligent, then we will take to devotional service. We'll take shelter of the Supreme Lord and get free of this suffering.
当一个人变得有智性的时候，他会脱离于奉爱的路途，他会回归家园。
So Maharaj Parikshit tells Sukadeva Goswami, you've told us about all the hellish life for the sinful people.
Maharaj Parikshit 跟 Sukadeva Goswami 说，你已经给我们讲述了所有的这些罪恶的人会去到的地狱的不同的状况。
That was in the fifth canto. And in the fourth canto, you told us about the first Manvantara, about the first Manu, who was Swayambhuva Manu, the son of Lord Brahma.
您在第五篇给我们讲述了地狱的不同状况。您在第四篇也给我们讲述了由一个 Brahma 的儿子 Swayambhuva Manu 管理的 Manvantara.
And you told us about the line of people coming from Maharaj Priyavrata,And Maharaj Uttanapada.
您还给我们讲述了来自于 Priyavata, Priyavata 来自于这条传系的这些人。
Uttanapada.
Uttanapada.
Uttanapada, the father of Dhruva Maharaj.
Uttanapada 是 Dhruva Maharaj 的父亲。
And you told us about all the different planets in the universe and the different.Environments everywhere.
您给我们讲述了这个宇宙不同的环境，不同的状况。
We know about the planet Earth, and we know about higher planets, the stars in the sky, and the lower planets. You told us all about this.
您给我们讲述了整个宇宙，整个宇宙，比如说高等的星系、星辰，还有土地。等等这一些。
And you told us about who's living in these different places.
您还给我们讲述了谁居住在这些不同的星球上。
So, Krishna actually created all these different planets for different types of living entities.
事实上 ，Krishna 创造了为这些不同的躯体创造了不同的这些星系。
So atheists say there's no God, there's no creator.They say everything is just by chance.
无神论者说没有一个创造者，一切都只是偶然发生的。
But they cannot explain why all these different planets are in the creation, why there's hellish planets, why there's heavenly planets.
但是他无法解释为什么有这各种各样不同的创造，为什么有天堂星球，为什么又有地狱星球。
We can see there's intelligence behind the universe.
我们可以看到在宇宙的背后是一种智慧。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, everything comes from him.
Krishna 在博迦梵歌中说，一切都来自于我。
Everything comes from Krishna.
一切都来自于 Krishna.
So when we understand that Krishna created everything,Then we will want to surrender to him.
当我们能理解到一切都来自于 Krishna 的话，我们才会想着要臣服于 Krishna.
But people are so stupid; they cannot understand Krishna's supreme position.
但是人们是如此愚蠢，他无法理解 Krishna 的至尊特性。
But if they associate with devotees and read the proper books, then they will come to understand.
但如果他们和奉献者联谊，阅读恰当的书籍的话，他会逐渐的理解。
Of course, it may take them many lifetimes because they're very sinful.
当然，这可能会花去他们很多生世的时间，因为他们太罪恶了。
So Vasudev Krishna is the creator; everything comes from him.
Vasudeva 是创造者，一切都来自于他。
So.In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says there's a combination of the material energy and the spiritual energy. The living entity is the spiritual energy, and he lives in the material world, which is the material energy.
在薄伽梵歌中，主 Krishna 说，在这个物质世界有物质能量，也有灵性力量，二者是相互组合的。灵性力量生活在这个物质世界。
So this is the combination, the spirit and the matter, material elements, and this is the cause of the creation.
这是一种物质能量与灵性力量的组合，二者组合在一起形成的创造。
So Maharaj Parikshit asked Sukadeva Goswami, he said, you're very fortunate. Now please tell me, how can human beings be saved from having to go to hell where they suffer terrible miseries?
Maharaj Parikshit 跟 Sukadeva Goswami 说，您是非常幸运的，请您仁慈地告诉我，人类要怎样才能免于受苦，得到拯救，从这种受苦之中得到解脱出来。
Right, and we read last week about the hellish planets and how people have to suffer so many different hellish conditions.
在上一周我们讲述了各种不同的地狱的星球的这些状况，人们是如何在这些地狱星球受苦的。
So, the devotee is thinking how to save people from hell.
奉献者想的是如何能够把人们从地狱之中拯救出来。
Prahlad Maharaj also prayed like that.
Prahlad Maharaj 也是这样祈祷的。
He said, I have no personal problems. He said, because I know how to glorify your qualities.
Prahlad Maharaj 说，我没有个人的问题，因为我知道如何荣耀您的超然的品质。
Said, my only problem is when I think about all these fools and rascals, how they're busy with material happiness, I'm concerned about them.
我只有一个问题，就是每当我看到这些恶棍和蠢人在忙于他们短暂的快乐的时候，我总是在担心他们。
They don't know anything about devotional service.
他们根本就不知道关于奉爱服务的任何的东西。
So this is a problem. We want to think how to help them, how to save them.
这是一个问题，我们希望帮助他们，拯救他们。
So a devotee takes full shelter of Krishna. He's not afraid. He has no problem about the world.
一位奉献者完全脱避于 Krishna 的，脱避于 Krishna， 他根本不担心这个物质世界。
But he is always thinking about how to save the conditioned souls from hell.
但是他总是在想着那些受条件限制的灵魂，怎么样去帮助他们，如何免于下地狱。
So Maharaj Parikshit is also thinking like that. How can I save all these people who are in hell and who are going to hell?
Maharaj Parikshit 也是这么想的。他想着如何从那些把那些人从地狱中拯救出来，如何让他们不要堕落到地狱之中。
So Sukadeva Goswami, he told about how people go to hellish life.And he could also, he knows how to save them from going to hell.
Sukadeva Goswami 已经解释过人们是如何进入地狱，他也知道如何这些人就不会去到地狱。
But the problem is people are so ignorant and uneducated, they have no Krishna consciousness.
但是不幸的是人们完全没有受到教育，也完全没有 Krishna 知觉。
And then when Sukadeva Goswami tries to teach them, they cannot accept.
此 Sukadeva Goswami 来教导的时候，他们不会接受。
And so they don't believe in the life after death.
他们根本就不相信在死后的那一切。
Because of they're so attached to sense gratification, they cannot understand there's another life after this one.
他们是如此的依附于物质感官享乐，他们也根本无法相信在有下一生。
So our duty is to try to save them, and Maharaj Parikshit is thinking how to save them.
因此，我们的职责是要想着如何拯救他们。Parikshit Maharaj 也是想着如何去拯救他们。
So Sukadeva Goswami says to Maharaj Parikshit, he said, if before one's death, whatever pious activities we've done in this life, we have to try, whatever pious acts we've done with our mind, with our body, with our words, or whatever impious acts, whatever sinful things we've done, if we have to count it, we have to do something to make up for them. We have to count, we have to atone for them.
Shukadeva Goswami 回答道, 在死亡到来之前, 一个人在这一生, 从事的任何不虔诚的活动, 比如说心意言语或躯体, 从事的任何不虔诚的活动, 他都应该找到一种正确的方法, 得以抵消它, 或者说忏悔的这种方法去抵消它。
So this is described in some scriptures like Manu Samhita. They tell about what you need to do to make up for your sins.
这些都在Manu Samhita的这些经典中描述到，比如说一个人做了罪恶活动的话，他应该做一些什么来抵消这种罪恶活动。
And if you don't do what the scriptures tell you, then you suffer. You go to hell. You have to suffer all the reactions.
但是如果一个人不去做这种抵消的活动的话，他必须得去受苦，他得去到地狱。
So Maharaj Parikshit was a devotee, but Sukadeva Goswami, he doesn't immediately speak about doing devotional service.
Maharaj Parikshit 是一位奉献者，但是 Sukadeva Goswami 没有立即给他讲述关于奉爱服务的力量。
He's teaching him something else. He wants to test him to see how he reacts.
他给他讲了一些别的一些事情，他想测试Sukadeva，测试Parikshit Maharaj的反应。
We know in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said if we surrender to him, he would free us from all sinful reactions.
主Krishna在《薄伽梵歌》中说，如果一个人完全臣服于他的话，他会免于所有的罪恶反应。
So Sukadeva Goswami could have told him immediately, you just have to, they just have to do bhakti, they just have to do devotional service.
Sukadeva Goswami 本可以立即就告诉 Parikshit Maharaj, 你只需要做奉爱服务就好了。
But he wants to test Maharaj Parikshit, he wants to see if he's really intelligent. And he's telling him, oh, you just do karma kanda, just do some karma kanda activities, you'll counteract the sinful ones.
但是舒克德瓦戈斯瓦米想测试一下帕瑞克希特马哈拉吉，想了解一下他的智力，于是他就跟帕瑞克希特马哈拉说：“哦，你只需要做一些业报活动 ，karma kanda 这些活动就进行忏悔就行了。”
So there are many scriptures which teach about how to do these karma kanda activities.
有很多的经典都在描述如何做这种 karma kanda 的。
And this way you can counteract all the sins which you've done.
这样的话，你就可以抵消你所有的罪恶活动。So
this was first recommended by Sukadeva Goswami.
这是Sukadeva Goswami 推荐的第一种途径。
Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami recommends Maharaj Parikshit, you should do some karma kandi activities.
Sukadeva Goswami 给 Parikshit Maharaj 首先说你得做一些虔诚的这些活动。
Because we know somebody's not a devotee, they won't do devotional service.
我们知道有一些非奉献者，他们也想从事奉爱服务。
So not everybody is able to take up devotional service, only the fortunate souls.
但不是每一个人都有幸能够从事奉献服务，只有那些很幸运的人才能够从事奉献服务。So
Sukadeva Goswami says, before the next life comes, as long as the body is there, you should make up for your sins, you should do some good deeds according to the scriptures.
Sukadeva Goswami 说，在下一次死亡来临之前，只要你的躯体还足够强壮的话，你应该迅速采取经典中的那些规定的忏悔之徒。
If you don't do something, some good deeds to make up for all your sins, then you're going to suffer the reactions more. You'll get more punishment.
如果你不做这些来抵来这些活动来抵消你的罪恶活动的话，你会遭受到更多的痛苦。
You have to consider about what kind of activities you did. Were you very sinful? If you are very sinful, then you have to do bigger atonement, greater atonement.
这得根据你的罪恶情况的大小来反映。如果你是非常非常罪恶的话，你得做很大的这种忏悔才行。
If somebody is a murderer, then they have to be hanged. They have to sacrifice their life to make up because they killed somebody.
如果一个人他是一个谋杀者的话，他应该被绞死，他应该这样，他才因为他谋杀了他人，这样去才能忏悔。
So it's actually good that there's capital punishment. It's good that murderers should be killed.
对于一个谋杀者来说，他如果被处死的话，这实际上对他来说是好的。
So a doctor, he knows if somebody, according to somebody's disease, he knows what kind of medicine to give.
一位好的医生，他知道根据病人的病情开具不同的药方。
If it's a very strong disease, you need a strong medicine.
如果他的病情很严重的话。他的药力也需要加大。
So somebody is a murderer, they need to be killed. They need to be killed because they've did a very sinful thing.
如果一个人他是谋杀者的话，他也应该被处死，因为他做了很罪恶的活动。
So when the government orders somebody to be killed, that's the mercy of the government.
如果政府要处死某个这样的这个谋杀者的话，实际上是对这个谋杀者的一种仁慈。
It saves that murderer from having to suffer more hellish life.
他能够帮助这个谋杀者免于更糟糕的地狱情况的处境。
So people, they don't know about the next life, but we know.
人们并不知道下一生，但是我们知道。
So.In Hindu society, we know about these things. Christians, even they also have atonement. They also do something to make up for their sins.
印度教的这个社团，他知道这个抵消罪恶的这些活动。基督教他也有他的忏悔之徒。
So Maharaj Parikshit, when he heard this, he said, Somebody may know that sinful activities are not good for him. And he sees that a criminal gets punished by the government.
Maharaj Parikshit 说，一个人或许知道罪恶活动对自己有害，因为他也目睹到这些罪犯得到政府的惩罚。
And he hears also from the scriptures that he has to go to hell in the next life for all of his sins.
他也从经典那里听到过，一个人如果从事罪恶活动的话，他在下一生会被投到地狱之中。
But somehow he does sins again and again, even after doing atonement, even after trying to purify himself from sins, he keeps on doing sin. He doesn't stop. So what's the good of the atonement?
但是他们尽管有这样的知识，尽管在忏悔之后，他们仍然不断地做这些罪恶活动。那这样的忏悔又有什么价值呢？
Sometimes sinful people, they may go to the church and they will tell the priest that they did some sins, and then the priest will tell them they have to pay a fine.
有时一个罪恶的人到牧师那里讲述自己的罪恶活动。表达自己的这种忏悔，还支付罚金。
And then after he pays money to the church, then he goes away and he does the same sins again.
当他把钱把这个罚金付给这个牧师之后，然后他又回去从事同样的罪恶活动。
And then it comes back again, and then again they find him and pays more money again. It just go on. It never stops the bad habits.
然后他回去从事罪恶活动又之后又去到牧师那里，又开始忏悔，又付钱，然后重复的这样。
So even 5,000 years ago, it was like that.
即便在五千年以前也是这样。
People would do sins, and then they would be punished, and then they would do them again.
人们从事罪恶活动，然后被惩罚，然后他们又来从事这些活动。
So Maharaj Parikshit has seen that people don't give up their sinful life very easily.
Parikshit Maharaj 看到人们并不很容易放弃他们的罪恶活动。
People are very attached to sense gratification. They will do sins again and again.
他们非常依附于感官享乐，而且一而再、再而三地从事罪恶活动。
And he'll keep doing it until it, somehow he has to be trained to stop trying to satisfy his senses.
因此，他得受到训练。去遏制住他的这种感官享受。
People, they may not want to commit sins, but they're forced to do it because they have a habit to do it.
一个不想从事罪恶活动，但是他由于他的这种习性，被迫的驱使要这么去做。
So, just doing some atonement, it doesn't stop us from sinful activities.
只是做一些忏悔的方法，并不能把人从罪恶活动之中拯救出来。
Yeah, somebody may be trying to stop doing sins, but somehow they do it anyway. They're forced to do it. They can't control their mind and senses.
有时他们或许做了忏悔之后开始停止，但是由于某种原因，他又开始从事这样的罪恶活动。
So this idea of trying to, trying to stop sinning and doing atonement, he said it's like the bathing of an elephant.
这种在从事罪恶活动，然后又忏悔，我们可以把它比喻为大象的这种沐浴。
Because we see the elephant, they take a bath, and they throw water over themselves, and then as soon as they come out of the water, then they roll in the dust, and they throw dust over their body again.
我们看到大象在沐浴完之后，把水啊往自己身上沐浴完之后，它一回到陆地上，就马上又把尘土喷到自己的身体上。
So Maharaj Parikshit was asking how somebody could be freed from sinful life, so that he would not have to go to hell after death.
因此 ，Maharaj Parikshit 问的是。一个人如何免于罪恶活动，这样他就不必再去到地狱了。
So Sukadeva Goswami told him that if you do atonement, that can stop the suffering.
Sukadeva Goswami 就此的回答是，他可以做一些忏悔的活动来抵消罪恶活动。
But Maharaj Parikshit did not accept. He said, "No, no, you can't trick me. I know this is not going to work."
但是 Maharaj Parikshit 他说这个不行，这个你也不能骗我，这个东西它不是一个真正的解决方法。
Sukadeva Goswami was testing his disciple Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 在测试他的门徒 Maharaj Parikshit.
It's the duty of the spiritual master to test the disciple to see how much he's understanding.
这是一个灵性导师的职责，他要测试他的门徒到底他学到了多少。
So Sukadeva Goswami, Maharaj Parikshit wants to get another answer from Sukadeva Goswami.
因此 ，Maharaj Parikshit 他想从 Sukadeva Goswami 那里得到另外一个答案。
So Sukadeva Goswami tells the king, he said, some acts may.Sometimes you can neutralize sinful activities, but that doesn't stop you from acting sinful again in the future.
Sukadeva Goswami 说，有一些活动可以综合，就是综合这种不虔诚活动的行为，但是这种活动不会使人放弃这种罪恶活动的倾向。
So people who do that kind of atonement after sinful activities, they're not very intelligent people.
因此，那些在从事完罪恶之后做一些忏悔活动的人，事实上并不属于真正有智慧的人。
These people are actually in the mode of ignorance.
事实上，他们只是处在愚昧形态之中。
Because their activity, their atonement won't take away the desire for sinful life.
因为他们的忏悔并不会把他们内心从事罪恶活动的欲望给真正的消除掉。
The person may, he may appear to be pious, but he will still be, he's still going to be sinful.
一个人表面上或许会看起来很虔诚，但是实际上他仍会从事罪恶的活动。
So the real atonement is to get perfect knowledge.
因此，真正的忏悔是得到完美的知识。
You can get perfect knowledge by understanding the Vedanta.
你可以通过在 Vedanta 之中得到完美的知识。
So Sukadeva Goswami understands that the king is a very intelligent devotee. He passed the exam.
Sukadeva Goswami 知道 Parikshit Maharaj 是一个非常好的奉献者，他通过了测试。
He is not willing to do atonement.
他不会去做这种忏悔之徒。
So now Sukadeva Goswami is saying, what you should do, you should be a speculative, you should cultivate speculative knowledge.
现在 Sukadeva Goswami 给推荐的是，你得做一些思辨的活动。
So,In the beginning, he was, first of all, Sukadeva Goswami said Karma Kanda. Now he's saying Jnana Kanda.
在最开始的时候 ,Sukadeva Goswami 推荐的是 Karma Kanda, 业报活动。现在 Sukadeva Goswami 推荐的是思辨 ,Jnana Kanda, 思辨之部。
Yeah, he's saying the real atonement is to have full knowledge.
Sukadeva Goswami 说真正的忏悔是完全的知识。
If we can cultivate good knowledge, then you can get free of your sinful reactions.
如果你能培养出完美的知识的话，这样你可以摆脱罪恶。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna compares people who have no knowledge, they're compared to donkeys, stupid animals.
在薄伽梵歌中 ,Krishna 说那些缺乏知识的功利性活动者被誉为是愚子一样。
They're karmis. They just know only sinful activities. They just work hard to get money for sense gratification.
有一些业报活动者，他们得到了钱之后，只想从事感官享乐的这些罪恶活动。
And the purpose of studying the Vedas is to understand Krishna, the personality of Godhead.
但是学习伟达知识的目标是让我们能够了解至尊人格首神 Krishna.
So if somebody studies the Vedanta but doesn't come to know Krishna, he only knows about speculative knowledge, then he's also a fool, he's a muta.
但如果一个研究伟丹塔伟达知识的人，他不去了解至尊主，只是在这个思辨上面反复的研究的话，他仍然是一个愚蠢的人 Muda.
Real knowledge is to understand Krishna and surrender to Krishna.
真正的知识是了解 Krishna 以及向 Krishna 臣服。
And then we can get liberated from all material activities.
这样我们才能够免于所有的物质活动的这些污染。
Sukadeva Goswami talks, gives an example. He said, just like if a diseased personSomeone with a disease, if they eat pure, uncontaminated food prescribed by the doctor, then gradually they get cured.
Sukadeva Goswami 做了一个比喻，如果一个病人他按照医生的话去吃那些没有污染的纯净的食物， 他逐渐会康复，不再受疾病的影响。
Yeah, the disease will not give him any trouble. He'll get and become healthy if he follows the instructions of the doctor.
这个病人如果遵循医生的指导的话，疾病不会再来给他带来麻烦。
In the same way, if we follow the principles of knowledge, we can gradually come towards liberation from material contamination.
同样的道理，如果一个人能够遵循知识的规范原则，他就能够逐渐的从物质污染之中解脱出来。
Yeah, if we cultivate knowledge, we'll become purified.
确实是这样的。如果人培养知识的话，他能够得到净化。
Even if the knowledge is just from mental speculation, still we'll become purified.
即便这种知识有时候只是思辨，但仍然他会得到净化。
So the platform of knowledge is better than the platform of just being on the platform of karma, just doing material activities.
因此，处在知识层面要比这种物质功利性活动的这种层面要好得多。
If one is on the platform of karma, then it's easy to fall into hell.
如果一个人处在知识的处在karma。功利性活动的处在功利性活动的层面上，他很容易去到地狱。
But if we are come to the platform of gyan, the platform of knowledge, then we won't fall into hellish life so easily.
但一个人如果处在 gyana, 处在知识的层面上，他不会那么容易堕落到地狱之中。
We're a bit safer than the person who's just doing karma.
那些从事在知识层面上的人会稍微安全一点。
The only problem is if you do gyan, you take the path of knowledge, we will think that we've become God.
处在知识层面上的唯一的问题是，他如果长时间的处于知识，他会认为自己是神。
You know, that of people who cultivate speculative knowledge, they often think that they've become God.
那些经常从事思辨活动的知识的人，他们经常认为自己就是神。
So, even they come to the platform of Brahman, they can fall down again to material life.
因此，即便一个人上升到 Brahman 的这个层面，他也仍然有可能会堕落。
Because they've never taken shelter of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
因为他从来没有脱避于 Krishna.
But the Gyani knows what is sinful and what is pious.
尽管如此 ，Gyani 思辨者他知道什么是罪恶，什么是虔诚。
So they're very careful to act according to the scriptures.
因此他非常小心的在从事经典中的这些活动。
And so we're going to hear about the different things which they do to practice this gyan, this path of knowledge.
我们会聆听到关于从事 gyana 他们所做的这些活动。
They have to concentrate the mind, and they have to practice celibacy.
他们得是心意专注，履行真守的生活。
And they have to give up all sense gratification.
他们得放弃所有的罪恶活动。
They have to control the mind and senses. They have to give charity.
他们得控制心意，得布施。
Give charity to help the poor people. They give charity to poor, unfortunate people, and they should be truthful and clean.
他们得布施，捐一些钱给那些贫穷的人。他们得说真话，他们得保持清洁。
And they should be non-violent and follow the regulative principles.
他们应该非暴力，遵循规范原则。
And they should chant the holy name of the Lord.
他们得唱诵主的圣名。
And so this way, if a person is faithful and he knows these principles and he follows, he can become purified of all sinful reactions.
如果一个人很忠诚，很 很有信心地从事这些规范原则的话, 他可以得到净化, 免于所有的这些罪恶活动。
But these sins, they're like dry leaves which fall at the bottom of the tree.
这些罪恶好比在树下面的叶子枯叶。
And they're at the bottom of a bamboo tree, and you may get a fire very easily, and all the roots will be burned, and all the trees will be burned.
这些树就是那些竹子树，竹子树下面有很多的叶子，它们很容易被烧成。 就是这些竹子树很容易就烧燃烧了。
But then the roots will grow up again after the fire.
尽管这些竹子、这些树以及这些叶子都会被燃烧，它们又会再，但是这个竹子又会再一次的生长出来。
So this is the process which the Gyani has to undergo. He has to do like this, to cultivate knowledge. He has to follow these kind of rules.
这就是那些思辨者要做的事情，他们得培养知识，遵循这些规范原则。
And they have to control the mind and concentrate on doing austerity.
他们得控制心意和感官。
In Krishna consciousness, we concentrate the mind on devotional service. This is the best austerity.
在 Krishna 知觉之中，我们把心意专注于 Krishna 知觉的活动，这是最好的苦行。And
to practice brahmachari life of celibacy, there are 8 different parts to it.
在 brahmachari 的遵守阶段，有八个方面要的活动。You should,
first of all, you should not think of women.
这八个方面的指导是：首先，第一，不应该想女人。
He should not speak about sex life.
他也不应该谈论性生活。
And he shouldn't waste time with women.
也不应该把时间花在与女人的交往上。
And he shouldn't look at women with lust.
不应该怀着色欲的去看女人。
And he shouldn't talk privately with women.
也不应该和女人单独的私下说话。
And he shouldn't engage in sex.
更不应该从事性生活。And
they should not try to have sex.
也不应该努力的想要去做性生活。So
we should not even look at the women, and it's better not to talk to them.
一个人甚至不应该想女人或看女人，更不应该和这个女人交谈。这指的是真守身的生活。So
that is called the first class brahmachari.
这个被称为一流的 brahmachari, 一流的真守身。
A brahmachari or a sannyasi cannot talk with women in a private place.
一个真守身或者一位 sannyasi 不应该私下的和女人谈话。
Because if they talk privately, then there's always a chance that they'll get involved in sex.
因为如果他们私下的谈话的话，总会有机会让他们滑向性行为。
So if one is a good brahmachari, he can easily control the mind and senses.
如果一个完美的真守身，他能很容易地控制心意和感官。
And he can give charity, and he can speak truthful.
他能给予布施，他能够说话真诚。
But in the beginning, he has to control the tongue, and he has to control eating.
但是在开始的时候，他得控制舌头，控制饮食。
So in Bhakti Marg, we have to follow also regulative principles. We also have to control the tongue.
在 Bhakti Marg 奉爱服务的道路上，人也必须遵循规范原则，控制舌头。
So we control the tongue by chanting Hare Krishna, and don't speak on anything except Krishna.
我们通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 来控制舌头，不去谈论与 Krishna 无关的话题。
Don't taste anything not offered to Krishna.
不要去品尝没有供奉给 Krishna 的东西。
So then it's very easy to be brahmachari.
这样就很容易成为一个 Brahmachari。
So the path of devotion is better than doing the path of karma or the path of knowledge.
因此，从事奉爱之徒要比从事 karma 和 jnana 知识之徒要更容易一些。
And it's good also to do austerity. One austerity is to observe fasting.
遵循苦行也是很好的。苦行之中涉及到一个就是戒食。
Right, and you should try to observe the fast as fully as possible.
一个人应该尽可能的完全遵守戒食的规定。
But too much eating will make it very hard to advance in spiritual life.
太多的过量的吃对于灵性进步来说是一个障碍。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Yuktahara viharasya yukta chestasya karmasu yukta swapno vipodasya yoga bhavati dukaha. That if somebody eats too much,A real yogi, he must be regulated in his habits of eating, sleeping, working, and recreation.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌六点一七中说，饮食习惯、睡眠、娱乐、工作有规律的这样的一位瑜伽师，他可以减轻各种物质的痛苦。
What's that? What did they say?
Hare Krishna.
Tam Shoshima. Okay. I'm muted. Hare Krishna, can you hear me?
Sakhi Mataji, 您也把 Guru 给静音了。
不是的。您得重新开一下麦。对，我刚才静音，然后您的麦也关掉了。
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, happiness and distress is very temporary. It's like the winter and summer season.
Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，快乐和痛苦都是很短暂的。
So we have to learn to tolerate these disturbances and not become disturbed.
我们应该容忍他们，不要被他们所打扰。
So that is actually sober. That is dhira. Mind is control.
这被称为 dhira， 不被打扰的。
Okay, we'll stop here.
好，我们今天讲到这里。
We'll ask if there are any questions.
Yes, let me see. Divya Shakti, the first question, 稍等一下。Divya Shakti 说，顶拜 Guru Day 的莲花族，谢谢翻译，我们怎样坚定的对 Krishna 的信心不动摇，恒常稳定的休息。 This is the first question. Obeisance to Guru Day's Lotus Feet.And I want to ask how to firm in Krishna consciousness, how to have the strong faith in Krishna, and how to practice Krishna consciousness very stability.
You have to associate with people who are strong in Krishna consciousness and who have faith.By their association, they can help you also to have faith.
你得和那些信心坚定的人的奉献者与他们联谊，通过和他们的联谊，你也会取得非常强大的信心，坚定的信心。
You need to get good association. And if you cannot get it with people, then you have to associate either on the internet,Or you associate by reading the books.
你得和这些奉献者们得到联谊。如果你们不能见面的得到他的联谊的话，你得在这个网上跟他们联谊，或者你 很有规律的阅读经典。
You can associate with the spiritual teachers by following their instructions.
你可以通过遵循灵性导师的训示和灵性导师联谊。
There are two ways to associate. One is by the vani, and one is by the vapu. Vapu means the physical body. Physical body is material. It's not eternal.
有两种与灵性导师联谊的方式 ，vani 和 vapu。vapu 是身体的，但是身体层面的这个联谊不是永恒的。
But the vani, that is eternal. So you have to take shelter of the teachings of the spiritual master.
但是 vani 是永恒的，也就是训示和教导是永恒的。你可以通过遵循灵性导师的训示和教导，永恒的得到他与他的联谊。
You should listen to Srila Prabhupada's lectures.
你也可以去聆听圣帕帕德的讲课。
We have a number of Prabhupada's lectures all translated to Chinese. You can listen to them.
我们看到我们有很多圣帕帕德讲课已经翻译成了中文，你也可以去聆听他们。
They're very instructive. You will get a lot of knowledge and guidance from them.
那里面有很多很好的训示，你可以在这些讲课里面得到很好的指导。
So we encourage you to regularly hear and regularly concentrate on this program of hearing and chanting.
我们鼓励你有规律的去聆听，有规律的专注的去聆听和唱诵。
And then your faith will start to increase as you follow the process more. You'll realize the process works and it's helping you. It's good for you.
这样你的信心就会得到稳定。你怀着稳定的信心再去工作的话，再去做奉献服务的话，你会体验到这个奉爱服务是有力量的，是有效果的。Next question.
Yes.
Next question. 也是 from Divya Shakti Mataji. She asked. 还有一个问题，因为我们的感官是不完美的，那我们怎么用不完美的感官去知觉到至尊主 Krishna 的临在呢？Because our senses are not perfect, so how should we use this imperfect sense to realize the Supreme Lord, Krishna?
You don't have to use your senses, you have to follow the instructions of the spiritual master and use your senses as he tells you. He tells you to chant. So you use your senses, use your hands to chant, your tongue to chant, use your hands to count on the beats, use your ears to hear. And you do these things, your senses will become purified.
你不用你的感官去感知Krishna, 你用你的感官去遵循，去追随，你用你的感官去聆听，去唱诵，去从事这些奉献服务，这样你的感官会得到净化。
Yeah, we have a material body, material mind and senses, but they become purified as we use them in Krishna's service.
我们有物质的感官，物质的躯体，但是当我们从事奉献服务的时候，这些物质的感官、物质躯体会得到净化。
The more you come in touch with Krishna, the more the contamination from the senses will be removed, and you'll develop pure senses.
我们越多的与 Krishna 建立连接，我们越多的物质的污染会被去除掉，我们会与 Krishna 建立连接。
Yeah.
Next question.
Yes.
Next question. I think from Rajendra Prabhu. 感恩亲爱的 Maharaj. 有关真守身的训练需要从小时候开始。我们半路出家，二三十岁的时候才接触 Krishna 知觉，这时候才接受真守身的训练。成为完美的真守身困难重重，都被训练了几十年，五六十岁了。还没有成为完美的真守身怎么办？如果怀着色欲之心进入萨利亚喜，岂不是更危险？ 危害自己的灵修，也危害残害整个社团，这种说法正确吗？Thanks, dear Maharaj. About the Brahmacharya practice, need to be practiced from the childhood. So, but when I become a Brahmachari, I just is already 20 or 30 years old. I become no Krishna consciousness. At that time, I know some Brahmacharya's practice. Become a perfect Brahmachari is very difficult. Practice almost 20 or 30 years. I'm already 50 or 60 years. I cannot be a perfect Brahmachari. So what to do?
Well, you do your best. Do the best. Make the best of a bad bargain. You and we say you came late. Chidalbi meohao. You know, you came late. You didn't get from the beginning of life, but still you're here and you're trying. And so you're doing the best you can. Krishna understands.
您做到您的最好。有一句古话说，做迟到要比不到好。你虽然是很晚才来修习 Krishna 之觉，但是如果你尽力尽自己的全力去做的话， Krishna 会知道的。
In this Kali Yuga, nobody's very perfect. In this Kali Yuga, we're all fallen souls.
在这个卡利年代，没有人是完美的。在卡利年代，所有人都是堕落的灵魂。
But we have the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. We have the chanting of the holy name. That's the important thing.
但是我们有主柴坦尼亚的仁慈，我们有圣名的仁慈，这是重要的。
We're not able to practice perfectly Varnashram. A brahmachari, they should live in the ashram with the guru. They shouldn't have any money. They should just live in the ashram.So we can't live like that.
我们无法修习完美的 Varna Ashram 这个职责。在 Varna Ashram, 一个 Brahmachari, 他和 Guru 在灵性导师在一起，他住在这个 Ashram 里面，没有钱，完全都没有钱。但是我们做不了这一点。
But Varna Ashram is not the process. The process is Bhakti Yoga.
Varna Ashram 不是我们的程序，我们的程序是奉爱瑜伽的程序。
So Ramananda Rai, Lord Chaitanya teaches that what we should just stay in whatever position we are in and hear about Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 告诉 Ramananda Rai, 无论在我们生命的哪一种情况，我们就处在那种情况就好了。同时，我们要唱诵 Hare Krishna.
By the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, we can go back to Godhead.
通过主柴塔尼亚的仁慈，我们可以回归守神。
Brahmachari, just perfect Brahmachari, doesn't mean you go back to Godhead.
但是如果只是一个 Brahmachari, 一个完美的 Brahmachari, 你并不能回归守神。Good day. Then he asked if with lust.Go to the sannyasi, it will become more dangerous than before.
Well, yes, if you're not able to control the lust, then it will be dangerous.
如果你有色欲，但是又不能控制这个色欲的话，这就会更危险。
The material world, there's lust.But that lust can become purified in the service of Krishna.
这个物质世界充满了色欲，但是我们的色欲可以被净化，用于服务 Krishna.
So, you just have to have the pure desire that you want to serve Krishna.
因此你要有纯洁的愿望，你只要去服务 Krishna.
You become a sannyasi, for the service of Krishna, not for any sense gratification, not for material position, but just simply for Krishna's service.
成为一个 sannyasi 是为了服务 Krishna, 不是为了那些物质的地位、物质的感官享乐。你是要去做奉爱服务。If a brahmachari go to the sannyasi and it will endanger one's spiritual practice and also harm to the entire community, is that right?
Sorry, what?
If this brahmachari with lust go to the sannyasi ashram, then it will harm. His own practice also will harm all the entire community. Is that all right? Is this sentence right?
Well, if you go to sannyas and your motive is not just for the service of Krishna, and if you go to sannyas and don't act properly as a sannyasi, then it won't be good. Then it won't be good for the community.
如果你成为 sannyasi 的动机不是为了去取悦 Krishna 的话，这样成为 sannyasi 可能对整个社团是不好的。
But if you're thinking you want to please your spiritual master, your spiritual master likes you to take sannyas, then you should think that you should do it for the service of Krishna.
如果你成为 sannyasi 是为了取悦你的灵性导师，你的灵性导师希望你成为 sannyasi, 这样是为了取悦 Krishna.
Our duty is to surrender. Do what Krishna wants us to do.
我们的愿望是臣服，我们臣服于 Krishna 希望我们做的事情。
Arjuna didn't want to fight. He didn't want to fight. He didn't want to kill his uncle, but Krishna wanted him to do it, so he did it.
Arjuna 并不想作战，他不想杀害自己的这些家人，但是 Krishna 希望他这么做，所以 Arjuna 去作战了。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Ye Qian. 顶拜咕噜和翻译，《薄伽梵歌》中导言中指出的五项基本真理是哪五项？Obeisance to Guru. In the Bhagavad Gita, it said five basic truths. I want to know what is the five basic truths.
Five what?
Five basic truths.
Physical.
五项基本真理。
Physical truth, is he talking about?
Basic.
Oh, uh-huh. So there's the Supreme Lord, Ishwara, there's the Jiva, the living entity, there's material nature, Prakriti, and there's time, and there's karma.
有至尊主，有个体灵魂，至尊主、个体灵魂，还有时间，还有物质自然，以及活动。
活动。
这是五项，对。Karma。业报。
OK, 业报。Yeah, those are the five truths. Five.
这是这五项基本的真理。
OK.
Next question from Devi Shakti. 顶拜咕噜和帕布，知道灵魂永生，但家人离世之后还是很难过，如何去面对？可以为他做一些什么呢？ From a new Bhakta, Yufei Madaji, Devi Shakti's friend. Obeisance to Guru. I know the soul is internal, but our family member.Leaving the body, I feel also very sorry. So how to face this situation? What can we do for them?
Well, we can chant Hare Krishna. That's the best thing for the soul when it leaves the body. You should chant Hare Krishna. And you can teach people that the soul is eternal. And the soul will go and take another body.
我们可以唱诵 Hare Krishna。 唱诵 Hare Krishna 对于这些离去的人来说是最好的最好的方法。
And you can also organize a feast in honor of the departed soul, and you offer the food to Krishna, and at the same time you offer a plate to the departed soul, and all the devotees come and they take the feast, and that plate which is for the departed soul, you don't take that food, that's offered to the, that's put in the river or buried in the ground or left for the insects or the animals to eat.
你也可以准备 一次大餐，在这一次大餐的时候，你请奉献者来到你的家里，你专门做一次大餐。这个大餐的时候，你给 Krishna 供奉一盘食物，然后给你离去的家人供奉一盘食物，给你离去的家人供奉的这一盘食物，你可以不让奉献者吃，最后只是放到水里，放到河里面，或者说植物，或者说这样的去处理。但是给 Krishna 供奉的那个食物可以派到奉献者的这个大餐里面，然后邀请奉献者荣耀 Prasadam。 这个活动是为了你离去的家人而做的这一次活动，这个是对你离去的家人一个很好的活动。
Because all the devotees will give their blessings on the departed soul, so help him for his progress.
这样的话，所有的奉献者会给予你离去的这个家人给予他们祝福，这对你的家人来说，这是一个对你离去的这个家人来说是一种是一个好的进步。
OK
Next Guru, next from I 亲爱的 Guru Day, 顶拜您的莲花组，一切荣耀归于施拉帕帕的，感谢主持人，感谢翻译。我为了平衡好我的灵性和工作，我可以在一些情况下不遵守公司的规定合理调整吗？比如联谊是周末，但是我周末刚好上班，我想去联谊，等这周内休假的时候，再去上班。这种调整店长其实是不同意的，我自己可以偷偷的这样做吗？找个工作的理由去找个工作的理由去联谊。A basis to Guru's lotus feet. I want to balance my spiritual practice and my work. Can I do some adjustment? For example, in this weekend, I need to work, but I want to associate with devotees. But maybe my boss are not agree. Can I do this adjustment privately? Because I want to associate.
I don't understand. Can I do adjustment?
He want to do this adjustment to change the time associated with devotees, but not tell to his boss.
Well, he can do it so long as he doesn't endanger his job, so he doesn't lose a job. He doesn't want to lose his job.
你可以如果这样做不会失去你的工作的话，你是可以这样做的，因为这样做不是一个特别危险的情况。
If you lose your job, then it's not good.
如果你会失去你的工作的话，这是不好的。
At this time, very hard to find jobs. There's many people, no job. You don't want to lose your job.
在这个时候，不是那么容易能找到工作，很难。找到工作，如果你失去工作的话，很难再找到工作。
So be careful.
因此你得小心。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Rajendra Prabhu. 进入气绝阶层之前，必须没有丝毫的色欲才可以或者安全吗？Become to be a sannyasi.Should it be without any lust, then I can go to the sannyasi life and all safe?
You have to be able to control your lust. You may have lust, but you have to be able to control it.
你或许有色欲，但是在进入 就是说你得控制你的色欲。
If you cannot control your lust, then you become degraded. You get angry all the time, and you have temper, and you lose your peaceful. You won't be peaceful. You'll always be agitated.
如果你不能够控制你的色欲的话，你总是会处于愤怒之中，你总是会处于这种焦虑和渴望之中。
So you have to be sure that you can be peaceful, that you're happy to just read and chant.
你得确保你能够控制，你只是在阅读、聆听和唱诵之中做这些活动。
Sometimes people think they want a wife, they want a companion, they like company, they don't like to be alone. You cannot be afraid of being alone.
有些时候人们会有这样的建议，我们需要一个伴侣，你不能一直就这样单身着。
We know sometimes as people get older, they become more agitated, and they see other people with their wives and with their family, and they think, oh, I also want to have a wife, I also want to have a home.
人越老的时候，有时候越会有这种焦虑和渴望。哦，我一个人这么老了，别人都有家庭，我也想要一个家庭，我也想要一个家。
So you have to be sure that you can control your mind and that you're happy as you are.
因此，你得确保你是否能够控制心意，能够让你保持这种快乐。
And you're happy to stay like this for the rest of your life.
你在接下来的这剩下的这些生命之中，你处于这样的情况下，你是快乐的。
And if you become the sannyasi, then you take disciples, then you have also disciples with you. They become your family.
如果你成为 sannyasi, 你会有门徒，你的门徒是你真正的家人。
And there are so many children, couples, they have children, and they're happy if the sannyasi takes the son with them and goes traveling with their son.
Sorry, Gurudev.
Couples, they have children, and when the children grow up, then the sannyasi can take the young boy with them traveling.
如果你有一些这个门徒里面是居士，他们有孩子的话，当这个孩子长大一点点的话，你可以带着他们的孩子一起去旅行。
Yeah, better than you don't have to worry about conceiving the child and then bringing up the baby. You just wait for the child to grow up and the young boy, and when it's a young boy, and then you take the boy with you traveling preaching.
你不需要去生育一个小孩，去养育一个小孩，还等这个小孩的。你只需要等待你的这些居士的家人的这个小孩长大，然后等这个小孩长大，你带着这个小孩去旅行就好了。
There's many couples, there's many ladies have got sons, and they're happy if their son will go with a sannyasi.
有很多女士，有很多居士，他们都有孩子，都有儿子。他们也非常乐于让他们的儿子陪一个三尼亚西去旅行。
Okay.
Next question from Hani Vamsa. 顶拜灵性导师，请问受罪的灵魂到地狱接受该有的惩罚后，已经消除罪恶，为什么还要投身另一个躯体接受罪恶反应呢 ？Obeisance to Guru. I want to ask if a sinful soul.Go to the hellish planet and get some punishment, then conquer the sinful reactions. Why this soul will get another body, get the punishment again?
Because he still does sinful activities. He still has material desires and he does sinful activities.
因为他仍然有这种物质罪恶的这种愿望，还从事着物质罪恶的活动。
Just like people, they get caught by the police and they get put in prison. And then when they come out of prison, sometimes they still steal again. And they get caught again, and again they go back to prison.
就像一个小偷，他被逮住了之后惩罚，进入到监狱， 等他从监狱出来之后，他又开始偷，又开始从事这些罪恶的活动，然后又被逮进去。
So some people they never learn to stop their sinful activities.
因为这些人从来不去学习如何停止这些罪恶的活动。
还有问题吗？
Yes, next question from Shanti Rupa Madhaji. 接着于飞 Madhaji 的问题，顶拜 Gurudev， 不方便请奉献者去家里，可以请奉献者在联谊的时候为他们祝福吗？或是念诵声明吗？ Obeisance to Gurudev. This question related to the family member passed away. I want to ask.It's not convenient to invite devotees to come our home, but can we ask the devotees when we get association with devotees, we ask them to give their blessings or chant the holy names for the family members?
Yes.
可以的。
You don't have to have the devotees come to your home. You can arrange a feast.Wherever the devotees have their program.
你不必请奉献者来到家里吃饭，无论这个节目在什么地方，如果有奉献者的话，你都可以安排在那个就是联谊的这个时候，在谁在什么家谁哪个地方有联谊的时候，你安排这个联谊的大餐就可以了。
But if you don't want to give a feast for the devotees, you can ask the devotees to pray for the soul. You can do that.
如果你不想请奉献者吃饭的话，你也可以请求奉献者，让奉献者为你的家人祈祷，你也可以这么做。
OK， 下一个问题。
OK， yeah， she ask next question from Bhakti 于月红， Bhakti 于月红，顶拜 Guru， 顶拜翻译，丈夫暂时不能同意没有性生活时，我能请求被启迪吗？ Guru 能接受我吗？其他的基本原则能够做到。 Hare Krishna. If the husband cannot accept without a sexual life, can I get initiated by the Guru Maharaj? Can the Guru accept me? The other principles I can do.
You have to ask the Guru.
你得去问你的 Guru.
But it's not very good.
但这并不是很好的。
If you get pregnant, what are you going to do?
如果你怀孕的话，你怎么办？
Are you going to have abortion? That's very sinful.
你是要去堕胎吗？这是很罪恶的。
You get couples, they don't want children.But they just want sex.
有一些就是居士，他们不想要小孩，只是想要性生活。
And then when they get older, you know, young couples, they say that no, we don't want children now, we'll have children later. When they get older, they can't have children so easily.
当他们变老的时候，他们没办法再要小孩了。因为当他们年轻的时候，他们想着等老一点的时候再要小孩，但是当他们老的时候，他们再没办法要小孩了。
No, supposed to have children at the beginning of marriage, not at the end.
最好是在一开始结婚的时候就要小孩，不要在最后的时候再要小孩。
Yeah, and you have to understand that sex is actually very harmful for the physical body.You're draining the energy from the man.
你得了解到性生活对身体其实是有害的。Draining the, 你是在 draining the energy of the man.
Yeah, because the semen, to make semen, one drop of semen, it takes 16 drops of blood to make one drop of semen.
你其实是在吸走男人的能量，因为一滴精液相当于64滴血液。
And to make one drop of blood, it takes 16 mouthfuls of food.
但是一滴血液是需要64 什么样的食物？六十四口食物。
没有六十四，十六。
哦，十六，十六口的食物。
Yeah, so you have to understand that to produce semen, it's the life energy of the body, and you drain a person's energy from the body every time you have sex.
因此，要培养一个培养一滴精液是这个精液是生命的能量。每一次你过性生活的时候，是在消耗这个人的生命的能量。
So you're not helping the man to maintain his life. You're ruining his health. You're taking away his energy.
你在拿走他的能力，你在拿走他的生命的这个能量，你在浪费他的这个能量。
People don't realize they're taking pleasure. They don't realize it's just suffering. They're bringing suffering.
人们并没有意识到这一点，他们只是在带来了痛苦。
Right? Another question.
Hare Krishna, good day. 沈阳的于一红马大吉，刚才他问的是，他的丈夫就是现在不同意他遵守这个原则，所以他想启迪，但是他丈夫就是对这方面不同意。
Okay, so husband doesn't matter. She can practice anyway. She's chanting. Follow what she can. She doesn't have to worry about initiation just now. Her husband is not favorable. So she has to be careful. She shouldn't make the husband angry. She should just continue her practice. And gradually, when the husband has a better understanding, then he may become more favorable.
她现在可以继续休息，等她的丈夫现在不太适合，她现在可以，这个妈的姐现在可以继续休息。
And hopefully the husband will become more favorable in time.
希望她的这个丈夫能够变得，更有利于的这个事情的时候。
Naturally, the husband worries about his wife, and he wants to protect his wife.
通常情况下很自然的这个丈夫他是想保护他的妻子的。
He doesn't want his wife getting any bad association or bad company.
他不希望他的妻子有一些不好的这个涟漪。
So she has to convince her husband that what she's doing is not harmful, that it's actually good.
Sorry, good day.
She has to convince her husband that she's not doing anything bad.
她得说服她的这个丈夫，她并没有做错什么。
So she should be patient.
同时，她也应该耐心。
And keep practicing, and gradually her husband will become more favorable.
继续的休息，等待她的丈夫变得更好一点点，更适合。
Okay.
好的，谢谢 Good day.
She's already started chanting. That is the real initiation.
她已经在开始念诵了，这是真正的启迪，这也是真正的启迪。
还有问题吗
？Yes. Next question from Rajarani Devadasya. Guru Maharaj, 请接受我的顶拜。朱哈玛拉吉去的星球是用恨的吗？在第四册瓦坛。写的我没有明白 ，Sati Maji， 这个问题怎么你是用恨的吗？我们先翻译下一个 ，Harini。Next question from Harini， 顶拜 Guru Day 的莲花族，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问，我跟我的母亲都灵修，对我已经去世近20年的父亲有帮助吗？感恩 Guru 的回答。A basis to Guru Day's lotus feet， I want to ask。My mother and me are all practice the spiritual So is this good for my father?
Yes.
Is it good for my father? Because my father passed away already 20 years.
Yes, it's good for your father. Everybody in your family line, they all benefit by your practice.
任何你家族的这个家族里面都会受到你们的都会受到帮助，只要你在这个修行。
Because a devotee has come in their family, so they're all benefiting from your practice.
当一个奉献者去到这个家里的时候，整个家族都会受益，通过这个人的修行。
So both Harini and her mother Krishna Priya, they're very nice devotees, and so certainly their family ancestors are all benefiting.
通过 Harini 以及他母亲的修习，他所有的整个家族祖先都会受益。
So keep practicing, and they'll get more benefit.
请继续的修习，他们会得到更多的益处。Next question.顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的翻译，请问纸质书和电子书哪个更好点？是不是纸质书更好一点呢？ A basis to Guru Maharaj, I want to ask the e-books and the books by the paper books, which are better? Is that paper books are better?
No, both are good.
都是很好的。Next question from new devotees. 顶拜 Guru, 奉献者之间的婚姻不想有孩子，如果一生之中把 Krishna 当自己的孩子可以吗？ A basis to Guru Dev. Devotees marriage, they don't want to have a child, but if they recognize the Krishna as their child, is that okay?
Yes, okay.
是可以的。是把 Krishna 当孩子是可以的。
Yes, husband and wife, they can live together, help each other, serve Krishna. They don't need to have sex if they don't want children.
妻子和丈夫可以相互的帮助，一起去服务 Krishna. 他们可以没有性生活，然后去服务 Krishna. 如果他们不想要孩子的话，可以没有性生活。
It's very good. That's nice spiritual life.
这是非常好的，这也是一个很好的灵性的生活。
还有问题吗？
萨提玛德吉，那个刚刚那个问题 ，Raja Rani 的那个问题，您能不能完整的给我发一次，到底是什么意思？Next question from 烟台。徐小元，顶拜 Guru， 据说中国藏传佛教的破瓦法度超度会把灵魂送到任何地方，用 Krishna 知觉怎么解释这些现象呢？ A basis to Guru, it is said that in Chinese Buddhism, they do some yagya, then can.Deliver the soul to any place. So, how to use Krishna consciousness? Explain these things.
Yes, Krishna consciousness will deliver the soul to back to Godhead.
Krishna 知觉能够把灵魂带回守神那里去。
But Buddhism, they can only put the soul in some place in the material world.
但是佛教它只会把灵魂去运送到物质世界的另外一个地方。
Because in Buddhism, they don't believe in any spiritual world.
因为在佛教里面，他们并不相信有灵性世界的存在。
Devotee has no desire to go anywhere in the material world because he knows all birth and death.
奉献者没有任何的愿望要去到物质世界的任何其他地方，因为所有的地方都是充满着生和死的。
So what is the point of sending a soul to another place in the material world? There's no point.
因此的， 因此把这个灵魂送到其他的地方，超度到其他的地方，又有什么用呢？对我们来说，
We've all been to so many places in the material world already.
我们已经在很多地方都待过了。
Now we want to go back to Godhead.
现在我们想回归守神。
Buddhism cannot take us back to Godhead.
佛教不会带着我们回归，佛教徒不会带着，佛教不会带着我们回归守神。
Only Krishna consciousness can take us back to Godhead.
只有 Krishna 知觉能够带着我们回归守神。
How you went, Ma?
Sati Mataji.
Hare Krishna, good day.
这个 Vrajarani 的 Mataji 的这个问题，我一直不明白，您能不能？
对对，我刚刚又问了他，good day， 他是这样，就是 Dwar Maharaja 那个去的那个星球。主赐给他的那个星球，他想问是永恒的还是会最后会就是消失的，就是也会随着毁灭的，就是物质世界毁灭之后，我们在瓦坛当中他有介绍说他是一直永恒存在的嘛，但是在他说在第四篇的瓦坛当中又看到说这个星球也是会最后也是会毁灭的，他现在不理解。
Yeah, I can understand. Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's a spiritual planet in the material world.
Dhruvaloka. Dhruvaloka is a spiritual planet.
But it's in the material world.
It's in the material world.
So when there's annihilation, then that time Dhruvaloka will become unmanifest.
Dhruvaloka 会不展示。
And then when there's creation, then it becomes manifest again.
当这个创造的时候，它才会展示出来。Next question from 一民，请问捐款布施时只写自己的名字，已经意味着整个家族都受益呢，还是说要写清楚其他成员的名字才受益呢？A new bhakta, he asked, when I do some donations, when I write only my name, it means my family member can get the benefit, or I should write the name.All my family members, then my family members can get a benefit.
Well, it's better you don't write any name. Then you get the greatest benefit.
你最好什么名字都不要写，这个你会得到最大的益处。
Because when you don't write any name, then you're giving the charity without...You don't want any recognition for yourself. You don't want people to know.
当你布施的时候，你不写任何人，你不写任何名字的时候，你会得到真正的益处。你没有任何的拥有感，你也不希望任何人知道。
But when you put your name, that's you want recognition. You want that's the mode of passion. That's not good.
但是如果你写上这个名字的话，这是处于激情形态的，这个并不好。
But when you don't,
你希望有一种认可感。
Yeah, when you give the charity without letting people know, that's the mode of goodness.
如果你给予布施，你并不希望别人知道的话，这是处于善良形态的布施。
So when you give the charity without people knowing it.Then you get benefit, and when you get benefit, then all your family they also benefit.
如果你给予布施的时候，你不写任何的名字，你就会受到益处。当你受到益处的时候，你的家人也会受到益处。
Because Krishna knows everything.
因为 Krishna 知道一切。
Okay.
He asked a detail. When I donation to the Mayapur. they give the receipt, they said they need a name.
Yeah, okay, so you give a name.
因此，那你就给他一个名字吧。
But you don't tell everybody.
但是你不要告诉别人。
You can put your family name if you want.
你也可以把你家人的名字写进去。
Finished?
Yes, I did again.
Okay. So we thank all the devotees. Mama Ganshi Fungshenza Nimandawenti Ganshi Niman Lingting Ganshi Subudu Rai Gimam Jintai Dafani Ganshi Sati Dujer Jufu Fungshenza Shanghok Kwaila Changsong Kwaila Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna.明白 Gurdei 感恩 Gurdei 的精彩讲课
Srila Prabhupada Ki